And with that, I'm going to ask Keith and Steve to come back up for a quick Q&A. Thank you.
Kurt, Keith, don't run away. You want to join us?
Sure.
Is this mic working? Okay. This goes back to looking at your demographics and your options package. And Steve, you may want to speak to this.
Yes, sir.
You got a demographics that's showing average age of 46, household income in, you know, six figures.
115, correct.
Last time I looked, this was the iPod group. But you're asking them to kick up an extra $3,500 for an iPod plug? Why isn't that standard equipment at the entry level when your competitors and, you know, folks coming in under you are offering it as a standard piece?
That was a great question. And we are going to incorporate that in our new navigation. We'll have a touchscreen navigation that we're bringing to the vehicle. Emily, the exact timing? For 2009, where we will have... Yeah, unfortunately, with the current radio, we were unable to do that in the vehicle. And we realize that that is a shortcoming for us. And we're working on to, again, bring that as standard on the vehicle as we move forward.
I'm just curious. I don't know much about marketing, but in the clips you showed us about the Bourne thing, why would you have the bad guy in the Touareg and the good guy in the Chevy Impala? Why wouldn't you work it the other way around? Yeah. It seems to me there'd be a little psychological thing there.
Well,
yep. That all the footage that you're showing of the Touareg ripping through the desert like that is just going to kind of not really sound very well to tread lightly, folks. So are you trying to position this as like a badass vehicle, or are you changing the... Because VW has typically been looked at as like, you know, down to earth, which people for the people, and now you're turning it into a bad guy, desert ripping. What's up?
Yep. Let me address this first, and then I'll address your question. Yeah, we talked about that, and in fact, obviously, we're not supposed to reveal much about the plot, but this character who drives the Touareg 2 ends up in the end not being a bad guy. Yeah, we talked about that, but yeah. I just ruined it, but yeah. No, that's not a big plot line, don't worry. But the we did talk about that, but the you know, you also have certain limitations, obviously. You know, with placement, you can't, you know, dictate what you want. But we think it works well. And then in regards to your question, no, we're not positioning it as a badass vehicle. I think what we're trying to do is to show under extreme circumstances and the capabilities of the vehicle and how those capabilities translate into the Touareg 2 that you're looking at behind us here. So we're not positioning it as any kind of evil, bad type of vehicle. There's no intent to do that.
Volkswagen has been a supporter of Tread Lightly as well.
On that same viewpoint, is Chevrolet allowed to use the same footage to promote the new Impala?
The what? I'm sorry?
Is Chevrolet allowed to use that footage to support the Impala?
Yeah, I suppose they could, yeah.
You're stressing off-road capabilities. Is there underbody protection as well? Skid plates, etc.
We do as part of an optional program, which we don't have here to show you today, but we do have underplate protection that we can offer as an option through our accessories department. And if I could jump in on just, and ladies, I wanted to update you on the horsepower of that 3.0. It is 230 horsepower on the 3.0 TDI we'll be bringing. We don't have official torque figures yet for that, okay?
John?
Yeah, I'm
not yet.
I'm sort of curious on your the extra money you spent on the off-road DVD, etc. Looking at the reasons why people buy off-road and that sort of thing is, you know, just, you know, a whisper in the wind compared to all the other reasons why they buy it. And it also doesn't seem to fit the demographic where people are, you know, I mean, that isn't what they do. They don't even see it, you know. It seems like a strange place to spend a lot of money as opposed to, you know, golf or tennis or something like that.
The objective, John, is to elevate those so that the next time one of those surveys comes around, four-wheel drive and off-road capability, we hope, rises up a little higher.
And again, you know, if we look at the active life cycle of style of our consumers, they do like to go camping. They like to go off-road now and then with this vehicle. And again, we need to let them know that, hey, this thing can handle anything. So feel secure that you can go to your job daily, go out to dinner, whatever. But hey, you can also go off-road and really experience what you like to do, be an adventurous type person.
And there's another component of the DVD that's sort of a product benefit piece that shows a CNC and each of the technological features utilizing the vehicle as well, so that you really understand visually like what the benefit of each of these you know, features is.
Guy's question back here at the rear. We're seeing this new marketing theme here, this Touareg 2. I understand there's no badge unit on the vehicle that will have the 2, but like when they came out with the redone Passat or the redone Jetta, we didn't see like the Jetta 4 or the Passat 3 or whatever, the next generation. Is this a theme that's going to be consistent with other Volkswagen products? Give us a little behind-the-scenes thought about that, the with all this marketing campaign, again, towards the Touareg 2, emphasis on the 2.
Initially answer that. when we talk about the Jetta and the Passat, those are truly all new vehicles from the platform ground up, where the Touareg 2, as I mentioned, carries a lot of the previous features. So it's more a facelift, I guess you'd say, than a total new generation. So we wanted to really point out to the public that even though it's not a brand new generation, there's so many new things and features in this vehicle that it does take that current Touareg to the next level, hence the Touareg 2 naming on that. Yeah, just again, to bring awareness, to give the salespeople and something to talk about to the consumer that, hey, the Touareg 2, well, why, what makes it a 2? And then that allows you to go into all the features and explanation of the new options and stuff we have available on the vehicle.
To wrap that together, ideally, first, it'll differentiate. Second, it will open up the conversation. What's changed?
Yeah, we would have to. Currently now, we would include the whole package as an upgrade and not just the actual leather seats. But the reason, I mean, we're comfortable with that because the standard interior, the VTEX fabric, is just like leather. It looks, feels, and everything. And you'll see in the V6s today, I believe, Keith, there are some equipped with that. So if we had cloth initially, I would say we probably would have a bigger concern not to offer leather separately.
What I'm saying is, the package is particularly...
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Correct.
Presentation of the interior features, I noticed this climate control REST, and if you describe that, I missed
it. Oh, yeah, killer feature. This basically allows you, particularly in the cold weather climates or in a cold weather situation, when you have been driven your vehicle around and the temperature is up to operating speed, you go to a shopping mall, let's say, and you want to park your car, you turn your vehicle off and hit that rest button, and basically for the next 30 minutes, it'll recirculate warm air throughout the vehicle. So you have to run into the shopping center for 10, 15 minutes, hit that button, and when you come out, it's going to be a very comfortable temperature within the vehicle, and that's what the rest button is. No, strictly for the heating. Correct, because the air conditioning, we would have to run the compressor in order to get the air cooled down.
Just quickly, you said that in the option package for the V6, I think the first one, heated rear seats comes with that package. Is that an implication that heated front seats are standard on all the vehicles?
Yes, sir. Great question. Front seats are standard, and adding them to the rear is just a great plus for us.
Kelly?
Yeah, currently for this vehicle, we have not investigated the cooling seats for the Phaeton. As you know, we did have an air conditioned or a cooled seat, but for the Touareg, currently we do not have a seat that offers that in the U.S. market.
Anybody else?
It's only sold in all our four
drive. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oh, for the front park assist, where are the sensors? I saw a little picture of them, but
yeah.
For the visuals. Inside.
In the top of the vehicle, right above the two trays. So, right here.
Top of the dashboard.
Of the dashboard, and then there's also a view in the back. Yep. When you look in the rearview mirror, you can see the lights also right below the window. Okay. Top of the rearview window.
Last question.
We do have a locking differential, yes, and low-range gear also, yes, sir. And that's operated by a knob in the center console, and you'll see that when you drive today.
For additional questions, all of us will be available. Several of us will be on the drive. Please feel free to approach us individually. From this point, just a couple of quick housekeeping announcements. First, we ask that our Canadian journalist colleagues stay in the room for a Canada-specific presentation. And then finally, let's be careful out there. Thank you very much.